in the backcourt for basketball supremacy in the state of Iowa. Raycom Sports and Entertainment presents Iowa Basketball. Tonight's game is brought to you by Bud Light, Amana, and Counter Lock and Load. Live from Carver Hawkeye Arena, the Iowa Hawkeyes meet the Iowa State Cyclones. A very pleasant good evening. Larry Morgan and Matt McCausland. That backcourt matchup we talked about, Skinner and Pearson, should be an outstanding matchup, but it is hardly the only one in this game, this battle of interstate rivals. Let's talk about the guys in the middle. For the Cyclones, Victor Alexander, all Big 8 last year. He's one of the best.
Well, Larry, when you look at this, you're talking thickness versus quickness. The big guy, Victor Alexander, 21 points. He has got an outstanding future ahead of him. He may have to shed a few pounds, but what it's going to take is also the quickness. That's the Iowa press. Full time, up and down the court. Victor may have trouble with it.
Alexander has certainly established his credentials in the middle. An up-and-comer at center, A.C. Earl. He blocked 8 shots the other night, 27 on the season. He's doing an outstanding job at both ends.
You're talking A.C. Earl, certainly a pleasant surprise. A.C. plays behind people, looks to block shots. He erases the mistakes. He's the detour man. You don't get to the basket without going past A.C. Earl.
Coming into this game, the Hawkeyes are 5-1. The Cyclones are 1-6, and I would suffice to say that at this point, both coaches have been surprised.
I would certainly think. You know, you talk Johnny Orr, certainly early in the year, thought he would have a different team here this season. They're not here. Some of those players, it's not been as successful. On the other hand, you look at Iowa. Iowa started off very well. Got an excellent play from some of the young kids. That's a surprise for Tom Davis this early in the year.
They don't give a trophy for the state championship, but that doesn't mean that both teams don't badly want it. The mythical state championship, Iowa and Iowa State, battling for a share of it. And we'll be back with a starting lineup right after these messages.
Roll with the clean, fresh taste of Bud Light. It won't fill you up, never lets you down.
Where is it? Oh. Dave, hi.
Hi. Remember those tickets your husband bought?
Yeah, sure.
If this is the only time you've been ticketed by the police recently, you might qualify for a special Farm Bureau auto insurance rate.
Thanks.
Call us for complete details today. If you're having a baby, look at all you get with HMO Iowa. Prenatal visits, delivery, postpartum, and all those well baby visits. Even a beeper just before your baby is due. No wonder HMO Iowa is healthcare you can feel good about. Member of the Principal Financial Group.
Hi, what can you do to help area lower-income families during the holiday season? Give to the Iowa Can-Do Food Drive, December 3rd through the 21st. KDSM Box 17 and Hardee's are asking you to donate canned food items for the Food Bank of Iowa. Simply drop off your canned food items at any area Hardee's restaurant. Your donation will go directly towards assisting lower-income families in your community and throughout Iowa. During this holiday season, do your part, for Iowa Can Do.
Now let's go to the public address announcer for tonight's starting lineup.
Home of Hawkeye basketball. Here are the starting lineups for this 43rd meeting between the Cyclones from Iowa State University and the University of Iowa Hawkeyes, a series which began way back in 1910. And one forward for Iowa State, for the Cyclones, a 6'1 senior from Springfield, Illinois, number 23, Doug Collins. At the other forward for Iowa, a 6'8 sophomore from San Jose, California, number 42, Jay Webb. And the centers for the Iowa State Cyclones. A 6'9 senior from Detroit, Michigan, number 52, Victor Alexander. At center for the Hawkeyes, a 6'9 junior from DeWitt, Iowa, number 43, Brig Tubbs. And the guards for Iowa State, a 6'2 sophomore from Flint, Michigan, number 24, Justice Thickpen. And one guard for Iowa, a 6'2 sophomore from Wichita, Kansas, number 20, Val Barnes. And the other guard for the Cyclones, a 6'2 junior from Palmer, Iowa, number 3, Brian Pearson. And at the other guard for the Hawkeyes, a 6-foot junior from
One change in the starting lineup, as you noted. Brig Tubbs will start at center instead of A.C. Earl. A.C. Earl was a little bit late for practice today, therefore Tubbs starts, but Earl will play. Let's take a look at the men who will be making the decisions tonight. On the left of your screen is Ed Hightower. J.C. Limebach and Ron Grissom will assist him in calling tonight's game. Now, before the game, a decision on whether Phil Coons, the Cyclone who broke a bone in his left hand, could play tonight.
As you look there, Eddie Hightower looking at Phil Coons' cast, decided he cannot. Rule 6 of player equipment specifically states any support item, that of leather, plastic, or metal, whether pliable or not, he cannot play, even if it's covered by a soft surrounding area, whether it be foam rubber or bandages.
43rd renewal of this rivalry. You mentioned there the Cyclones won here 2 years ago, but they have not won here many times. They stand 2-19 in Iowa City.
To go along with that, they also ruled that Jim Bartles of Iowa, who broke a finger and has it in a cast similar to that, cannot play in this game either.
Alexander at 6'9", Tubbs at 6'9" to jump. Hightower tosses the ball up, and it is Iowa State with the opening possession. Cyclones off to their worst start since the 75-76 season, but have played a brutally tough schedule. Iowa opens man-to-man defensively. Collins wants to post up underneath on Davis. This is Thigpen. Underneath, Dorfeld in a crowd, draws coverage, and is fouled by Brig Tubbs.
He's got a battle inside. Webb trying to reach around Dorfeld. Tubbs coming to support. We got two people going up against Dorfeld, who is an excellent free throw shooter.
He is seventh in the conference last year, Dorfeld. This year, 75% from the line. You look at Brig Tubbs getting his third start of the season with A.C. Earl opening this game on the bench. Cyclones on the board first. Johnny Orr got his 400th coaching victory to open this season, but the next one, 401, is a lot more difficult for him to accomplish so far.
This could really be an up-and-down game, Larry. Right now, you've got Iowa State out there pressuring, and you know Iowa will do the same thing.
Val Barnes fires for the Hawks, leaves it short, and right there to put it back is Rodell Davis, and the game is tied at 2. Both coaches wanting to up the tempo over last season, but neither played to their style, neither able to get it up and down the floor as quickly as they wanted to last year. Open, Dorfeld, and the Cyclones regain the lead.
playing healthy at Iowa State. It's been a long haul for him to try to get healthy, and he finally made it this year. Jay Webb bringing it up.
I would really wonder, Iowa State pressuring, you know, what that will mean, especially to Victor Alexander, who doesn't really have a replacement. Phil Coons has been a strong replacement center. You may have to see Bergman in there playing that post position.
Shot of Tubbs kicks out. The rebound by Doug Collins. Collins only 6'1", but he does things so very well in the traveling violation. He'll give it back to the Iowa Hawkeyes.
Cyclones getting the ball at the court. The Hawkeyes getting back, defending the basket well. Dorfield trying to take it down the sideline.
Alexander will defend. His inbounding will be Jay Webb. Game a minute and a half old. Cyclones on top 4-2. Skinner chased by his high school teammate Pearson. Nice pass underneath. Tugs on the pump, doesn't get the shot because of the looming presence of Alexander. But Rodell Davis will follow. Webb can't control the rebound. Iowa State gets the basketball. The game's first change will be made by Tom Davis, as he will send James Moses into the lineup, and Val Barnes will leave.
The Hawkeyes playing Tom Davis basketball, just on the boards, getting those offensive rebounds. But Tom Davis just is really known for his aggressive play by the team.
Leading the break for the Cyclones, Doug Collins. Iowa State off quickly, up 6-2. A basketball team, we mentioned, with a very difficult early schedule, and what they would like to do is get off to a quick start, which would really build their confidence.
Well, the interstate games, there's no question, they're played with a different level of emotion.
Hawkeyes patiently looking for their shot. 17:35 to go first half. Dorfeld gets in the way and knocks the pass down intended for Jay Webb. And the change for the Hawks is Rodell Davis. We'll get a breather. And comes James Winters, the freshman from Joliet, Illinois, averaging 2.7. Interesting that James Moses came off the bench first tonight as a guard.
I was going to say, what you've got now is a switch where Moses is playing that guard and Winters is playing the three position. Usually he's backed up Jay Webb.
Ball kicked out of bounds by Iowa State, and so the Hawks will play it 6-2. Iowa State with the lead. Cubs flashing open to get the ball. Both teams opening in man-to-man defenses. Both could show zone tonight, though.
I think you'll see a lot of combination man-to-man zone defenses out there.
Good battle inside. The 23s were going after each other, Collins and Winters. And they got Winters. You're going to see him look like a WWF hold, I think. Mac, you'd recognize that one.
That's right there is a half Nelson. And the call goes against Winters. I don't think there's any question that that particular case, the Iowa State player just grabbed the neck of Winters. Foul could have gone that way.
A.C. Earl now into the Iowa lineup for the first time. Again, not starting. He was late for practice today, but he is in at the 17-20 mark. Collins underneath. Doug Collins, who is 6'1", really makes things happen as two quick baskets, and the Cyclones off to a quick lead. And a backcourt foul against Alexander.
Good job that time by Skinner trying to step through that double team.
Val Barnes back into the attack for the Hawkeyes. And Troy Skinner will get his first breather.
And now you'll notice Barnes is playing the point guard. Kevin Smith not into the game.
Tom Davis does have some flexibility with this young basketball team, and he's exhibiting it here in the first 3 minutes of play.
Barnes has really become a leader for this Iowa team. He wants the ball at crunch time. Smart player.
Webb rebounds the Moses miss and puts it back, and the team's leading rebounder, averaging 8 a game. Jay Webb gets an offensive rebound and Iowa's second basket. His Big Ten bringing it down quickly for Iowa State. Cyclones up 8-4. The three, nothing but court for Doug Collins. He's red hot, 7 points to start the ball game. Val Barnes answers for the Hawks. Barnes averaging 11.3 coming out of a junior college in the state of Kansas, Butler County.
That's what Barnes can do, take charge of a game. He can go one-on-one, get the team back into the action.
Here is Thigpen letting fly, and Iowa State is shooting red hot to open the game.
And that has not been the history. They have had some bad shooting halves.
Barnes at the other end. Barnes is 2 for 2. This kind of game really favors Val Barnes' offensive style.
Yes, it does. Open court, be able to use, and Iowa State is yet to miss. 5 for 5. Make it 6 for 6. Yeah, right.
Pearson, who leads the Cyclones with 3-pointers, has hit his 15th of the year. And a torrid pace being set by Iowa State and Iowa early, and the Cyclones have been in front all the way and now lead it 16-8. So far, Alexander's done a good job keeping the roll from underneath the basket. Dorfell takes it to the baseline, and the Cyclones still have not missed.
That time just a bad no call. AC Earl hacked over the arm by Alexander.
Barnes hits his first two, misses that one. Alexander, who got 11 rebounds against the Hawks last year, with another. And Collins scores again.
That time Barnes goes to the basket. Nobody rotates back out for defensive position. And the Hawkeyes fall behind by 12.
That Collins averaging 12, has 9 already. Isn't it interesting in recent games in this series that Iowa State has usually had one player explode in scoring? Here is Collins again with Winters trying to catch it. And he does.
That is a great block. James Winters made a mistake not coming to the ball and makes up for it with hustle.
Iowa down early by a dozen points at 20-8. Earl puts it to the floor, and Alexander not getting it to go down. Thus far, Victor Alexander's done a good job keeping AC Earl away from his favorite shooting areas. The Cyclone missed a shot, and it had been a while. Now Pearson again for 3. And Barnes has the rebound.
This is a fast-paced game. You're going to need a lot of substitutes to sustain this pace throughout, and that would favor Iowa at this particular juncture.
Especially with Phil Coons unable to play tonight due to the injury. Barnes on the penetration. And Alexander rips it down. Big Pen against Moses.
Cyclones are just getting too many opportunities. 2-on-1, 3-on-1 against Iowa.
Barnes on the drive. It will count, and he is fouled on the way in. Val Barnes, a chance at a 3-point play. He's been Iowa's offense, has 6 of their first 10 points.
Val Barnes, knowing Victor Alexander is not a great shot blocker, just a total of 6 on the year, challenges him, makes Alexander come to him. 2 fouls on Victor. He's going to have to go out. As we said, the replacement situation has changed. It's now Bergman rather than Phil Coons coming in.
And, of course, not only do you lose the size of an Alexander, but also the experience. Bergman off the bench, a redshirt freshman from Waverly, Iowa, where he played for his dad. Bud Bergman, and the rebound is taken by Bergman.
And Iowa has Chris Street get in. Did not play in the first game back from the 2-game layoff that he had.
He played the opening 2, in fact, started those, then the suspension. Missed 3 on the suspension. One was eligible for and didn't play. AC Earl, 28th block of the year, first of this game.
And Iowa now has gone to zone. You can look to see if they're going to try and pack it in or whether they'll extend and come out to the shooters.
Cyclones have missed their last 4 shots after hitting a bunch to start the game. Now Collins leaves it short, and the rebound taken down by Davis. Getting in the way, Collins. And who's got it? Hot potato time, and the Hawkeyes come up with it. Barnes.
This is really a rough physical game, more physical than we've seen any time earlier this year, Larry.
Barnes has 8 of the Hawks 12. Iowa State with the ball and an 8-point lead. Pearson. Iowa State has now missed 6 in a row. Big Ten tries to change that and does. Sophomore Letterman from Flint, Michigan, averaging in double figures at 10 a ball game, gives the Cyclones a 10-point lead. Moses misses the 3. He is fouled, however. Big Ten, with the personal, it will be his first and the Cyclones' 3rd. Alexander with those two fouls and come right back in, Mac, because Johnny Orr didn't think he could spend a lot of time with Alexander on the bench.
I think also he's short substitutes. He's coming in with Dorfeld, moving Bergman over to the power forward position. So he's got to rotate some players at the pace this game is going. And again, the Iowa team really has 12 players deep that they can go to with Street returning. It adds a lot of flexibility for Tom Davis.
Here we see a new rule in college basketball this year. You get fouled on a three-point attempt, you get three free throws. Ironically, Johnny Orr was telling us earlier today he hadn't seen that in the game that he'd been involved in all year, just once on TV. Now he's seeing it, much to his chagrin, right in front of his bench.
And Moses had not shot well from 3 points. Now goes the opportunity to boost that free throw average up there. And he gets all three.
He's been only 12 of 23 from the free throw line, but can those three. And so the Hawkeyes, down by as many as 12, are back within seven. Iowa State sets the early pace to score. Cyclones 22, Hawkeyes 15.
A manor presents a refrigerator that simply rolls into place to sit flush like a built-in, but without the built-in price. It'll make your kitchen look flat out terrific. A manor.
Farming has always been a hands-on kind of business, but the makers of Counter have changed that. Introducing new Counter Lock and Load. The outstanding performance of Counter in convenient returnable containers. When locked onto specially fitted John Deere Maximerge hopper boxes, each sealed container opens automatically. Just lock it on and it loads. Protect your crop, yourself, and the environment. New Counter Lock and Load.
As you brave another cold winter, remember a manor. With efficient, dependable heating systems, people have been warming up to night after night. A manor.
Cyclones are setting a torrid pace thus far. Iowa State has led most of the way, with the exception of once when the game was tied to two with blazing shooting.
Yeah, Iowa State started with 6-for-6. Iowa a little cold, but they've hit that rebound once again. Offensive rebound being a factor for the Hawkeyes.
Put on the pressure as Bergman out of the backcourt against Webb. Now Pearson will bring it up. Underneath it's Alexander muscling in. He is fouled by Tuggs. The shot will count, and Alexander has got his first hoop of the game. Last year against the Hawks, 13 points, 11 rebounds in a game that went down to the wire, and the Hawks came from behind to win 89-87.
Iowa has their hands full. Once the ball goes in low to Victor Alexander, people have to drop down. Brig Tubbs, no match physically for Victor Alexander that time.
Alexander coming off a season low, 15 points against Baylor on Wednesday night, but he got only 8 shots in that game, so you know the Cyclones plan to get him the ball more. There's Kevin Smith into the Hawk lineup for the first time, the freshman from Fort Worth. His average is 6.5 per game. Davis tips the Webb miss.
Great job by Rodell Davis. Stepped inside Victor Alexander, blocked out, and then went up around the rim for the tip-in.
Cyclones by 8, number 13 into the Iowa State lineup. Mark Chappelle, junior college transfer from Lincoln Junior College in Illinois. Alexander, his presence felt on the board. His second bucket is 5th point. So now Skinner the off guard with Smith in there at the point. Cubs inside for the Hawks.
Expect Iowa to really try and run their offense, Larry. See if they can get the ball inside, maybe draw another foul on Victor Alexander.
Davis in a crowd and is fouled by Iowa State. Bergman on the reach and trying to help out defensively that time.
Rodell beats his man on the perimeter. Cyclones collapse. Bergman goes right across the arm.
Barnes checks into the lineup at a guard spot for Iowa. And Dorfeld comes back for Iowa State, taking the place of Mike Bergman.
It's a bit surprising. Rodell Davis, 0 for 2 for the year. And here is a young man that really does post up a lot. Doesn't get fouled that often.
You saw the graphic there. He's doing nothing wrong in this collection of shots from the floor, hitting 66%. But he cans his first free throw of the year.
And that's what Rodell does do well. Plays within the team concept, knowing what he can do, where he should take those shots.
Alexander with another early rebound. He's really been a presence on the boards this game. He averages 9.4 rebounds. That, of course, best for Iowa State.
Watch the Hawkeye zone. They come out. They're looking for shooters.
Pearson over the zone. Winters with the rebound. Hawks want to run. Pearson deflected it, but Earl gets it back.
Oh!
Winters got the roll, got the shot. Let's see if it'll count. Pearson picking up the foul.
Right there, deflection. Iowa regains the ball. Aciero trying to draw that third foul. Does a fadeaway. If he goes into him, Victor Alexander has to back away. That time bothered AC a little bit. Ball goes up and does not go down. James gets two shots.
Misfires on the first. And the second, and the Hawks now. Just one out of five from the foul line, while Iowa State has hit all three of their free throw opportunities. The penetration by Chappelle, and AC Earl gets up there to get a piece of it.
Boy, oh boy. What a great shot blocker.
He is something else. Pearson falls down, and Barnes gets the shot, and Val Barnes did double figures already with 10.
Barnes, great job of body balance, got bumped. Just made a pivot. That's where you keep yourself low. Pivot. Gather up and get your shot.
Dorfeld with the offensive rebound. Here's Chappelle. And the Cyclones continue their torrid shooting. And they have the lead back to 9 at 29-20. 9:55 to go in the first half. Barnes tries to answer for the Hawks. And Alexander again a rebound. Collins doing a good job flagging down the pass. Perhaps a little tall, but Collins was able to reach back, get it, put it in. He's got 11. The Cyclones lead by 11.
By now, Victor Alexander did not get down court at the offensive end. You can tell he is tired.
Barnes puts up the beauty. What a shot by Val Barnes.
He's just a prime-time performer.
AC Earl's big hand to have affected Collins as he tried to slam it. And a timeout is taken. Johnny Orr happy with his team's play thus far because they have set the pace, leading by as many as 12. Their current lead is 9. And we'll be back after these messages from your local stations.
Subway bakes my bread up fresh and that's my way.
Take home a sub with fresh, delicious seafood or cold cuts and be a hero.
Pioneer brand 3362.
Triplett Corporate Interiors presents office system design solutions that appeal to your visual line and to your bottom line. Triplett Corporate Interiors features state-of-the-art space planning and quality brand name office systems like Westinghouse, Shaw Walker, Ref, and Gianni. At Triplett's, we listen to your need, then customize your office solution. Consult Triplett Corporate Interiors, a Triplett company. Triplett's. We belong in your office.
Larry, you look there, you see the quote Tom Davis said today, the good players I've coached don't have to be told to do things. That was in response to a question we asked about Val Barnes taking charge. Here's how Val Barnes takes charge. Just a great move.
And he has the night. He has 12 points of the Hawkeyes 22. Iowa State leading at 31-22 as play resumes. Skinner against Pearson. What a high school career they had. 102 victories, just three losses the 4 years that they played at Palmer. For Troy's dad, Alden Skinner, who is at courtside watching tonight, as he most often is when the Hawks are home. A clear out for Barnes. Iowa State doing a good job defensively on Barnes that time.
Barnes got double teamed. Once again, I'm just so impressed with this young man. He has great knowledge of the game. He got rid of the double team problem. Alexander does a good job sticking in there with Thigpen. Then, after the kickback, he decides he can post up because Alexander leaves. He has an advantage. The man fouls him.
And that on the kickback, Thigpen fouled him the next time. Webb in the lane, tries to go up against Dorfeld, and a foul spotted on Pearson. Pearson with his second foul. The Cyclones now have their sixth. Meanwhile, Iowa a long way from sending Iowa State to the line because Iowa's committed just three team fouls. Webb 57% at the line. Iowa as a team just 61% from the line, but if you subtract Troy Skinner's total from that, it's not even that good.
No, you're looking at Troy Skinner 93, the Iowa team without Troy 58%.
And the Hawks have certainly struggled at the line so far tonight. Collins finds Dorfeld on the baseline.
What great rebounding to get inside. Somebody's got to call and give team help. They say, same team, or it's yours, AC. Instead, four players going as you look at Coach Hallahan.
He's been a head coach at East Tennessee State, brings a lot of experience to Johnny Orr's bench. Iowa has never led in this game. Cyclones have led by as many as 12. Their current lead is 8 at 31-23. 8:20 to go first half. Thigpen fires a three. Dorfeld with an offensive rebound. But a push-off is spotted against Iowa State.
When Iowa State had its biggest lead, Iowa was man-to-man, Larry. Now they've gone zone. And so far, I'd have to say their zone defense has been extremely effective. If you look over their victories, you've got Harstead from Creighton, and you've got Muhlenberg from UNI. Normally go to the free throw line a lot, but the Iowa zone shut them down, didn't allow them to drive, penetrate, and get that inside position. Those two players did not get a free throw in the two games earlier.
Davis brings Iowa back to within seven. Speaking of Northern Iowa, they were upset this afternoon by Morningside.
Well, I'd have to say that was a surprise, I'm sure, for Eldon Miller, and of course, they may have been looking past that game, the players, because they play Iowa State next Tuesday in the Dome.
Davis at least it on the lip, but Webb with the offensive rebound. Webb with his fifth point, his second basket off an offensive rebound tonight. Something Jay Webb just does better and better each time out.
I'll tell you, he may be the surprise of the year, at least as far as I'm concerned.
Cyclones one time 12-point lead, now down to five. As Alexander hits Dorfeld. Dorfeld with his 8 point. He comes in averaging 8.7, so he has had a good first half. Collins knocks it away from Davis. And then a foul is spotted on Collins. Collins with his first foul, the Cyclones with their ninth as a team.
Talked about Rodell Davis really being a strong post-up player. Good entry pass by Val Barnes. Rodell tries to go up, gets fouled across the arm, nothing called. Then he has to drive into the center before he does get the call. And again, this is just Rodell's fifth free throw of the year, but more aggressive now on the block, taking it to the basket, looking to get fouled.
Free throw percentage by Davis, of course, prior to hitting the two tonight. Into the lineup for Iowa State comes Brad Pippett, junior out of Des Moines. Lincoln High School, went to Northern Iowa Area Community College the last 2 years, where he was an all-region performer.
right up there for Coach Herb Knoing's mark.
Iowa State now sees the lead shrink to 5 at 33-28. James Moses into the lineup for the Hawks. He won't be able to play for a moment because first we have a timeout on the floor. This game has had all the intensity you expect of an interstate rival so far. Cyclones on top, 33-28. We'll be right back.
December, get a great gift for coffee lovers. The Mr. Coffee 10-Cup Automatic Brewer from True Value Hardware Stores. It features automatic pause and serve, so you can get that first cup as it's brewing. And it has a warming plate to keep the coffee at the perfect temperature. In December, get the Mr. Coffee 10-Cup Automatic Brewer for just $14.99 while supplies last at participating True Value Hardware Stores and Home Centers.
Roll with the clean, fresh taste of Bud Light. It won't fill you up, never lets you down.
Farming has always been a hands-on kind of business, but the makers of Counter have changed that. Introducing new Counter Lock and Load, the outstanding performance of Counter in convenient returnable containers. When locked onto specially fitted John Deere Maximerge hopper boxes, each sealed container opens automatically. Just lock it on and it loads. Protect your crop, yourself, and the environment. New Counter Lock and Load.
Starting forwards have been outstanding for Iowa State. Doug Collins with 11 points, Paul Dorfeld with 8. As far as the Iowa Hawkeyes scoring, Val Barnes with 12 and Rodell Davis with 8 leading the way.
Well, you talk about a shocker statistically. Iowa, 0 assists, and Iowa State, 11 assists.
Now here's a statistic to watch all night, because on the season, Iowa out-rebounding opponents by 6, Iowa State being out-rebounded by about 5.
Right now, Iowa State up 1 on that one.
7.5 before halftime. Watch Alexander and Earl inside. You see AC trying to keep him out. Now they get it to Alexander, who leaves it short against AC Earl, who is right up next to him. Skinner finds Earl. So both teams try to work it to their big guys, and neither succeeds on that exchange.
I'll tell you, there's a lot of physical activity in there that in other games would have been called fouls.
They called all the contact in this one. They'd be whistling a lot, wouldn't they?
Well, you know, Johnny Orr said his team has not committed 10 fouls in a half. They've already got 9, so the next one, Iowa will be shooting the two-shot free throw the rest of this first half.
Of course, Iowa's style of offense tends to get them to the line a lot. They have attempted 84 more free throws than opponents have this season.
Iowa State going to a zone. I would imagine a couple reasons. One, to help Victor Alexander stay out of foul problems. Also, Iowa State may be a little tired, and they're going to check Iowa's outside shooting ability.
Of course, Alexander already has 2 fouls. Here's Big Pet on the dribble. Now Dorfeld, he's been hot so far. Kevin Smith with the rebound. Coast-to-coast to score for Iowa.
That's a stop and pop. Okay, he's got great balance. He comes into that, low to the ground, controlling the basketball, and goes straight up.
Game similar to the game last year. Iowa State built a huge first half lead, up by as many as 18, but at the half by 14, but Iowa caught him and won at the end. Here's Alexander on the turnaround. He now has 7 points and 6 rebounds.
Great pass. Moses just not able to control that bounce pass from about 40 feet away. Great vision by Kevin Smith.
Don Davis sending Jay Webb back into the lineup. Rick Tubbs also comes in as out goes Winters along with Earl. 5:40 remains in the first half. Iowa State leads it 35-30.
Webb and Alexander establishing position low on that block. Webb trying to get help from the backside.
Webb spent a lot of time in the weight room this summer. He needs all those muscles against Victor Alexander. Here's a travel called on Thigpen. He shuffled his feet as he started to drive up the baseline. Johnny Orr, 19-11 in his career against the University of Iowa. Of course, a lot of those at the University of Michigan.
Looking, Alexander needs to work, try and get that ball. Webb doing a tremendous job of just fronting, denying him. Wherever the ball is, Webb's going to be in front. Make him throw a high lob pass over the defender to get it to Alexander.
For the game, with the pace as it is, a remarkably low number of turnovers. That's something that really plagued Iowa State. Baylor had 21 steals against him Wednesday. Johnny Orr said that was atrocious. We will be better. And his team's improved in that category in a hurry.
Now, I'll tell you, Victor Alexander is really pressing his luck, not picking up that third foul. He's been bumping with the body.
Pearson fires. He was hot early and had trouble lately. And with a rebound is Jay Webb. And Webb continues to pound the glass hard. Barnes on the penetration. Alexander with another rebound. At least seven for Victor Alexander. He's already had 14 rebounds in a game this year, and that was against a pretty good opponent, North Carolina. Cyclones have had a few good opponents this year. Top 10 teams, Syracuse and the Tar Heels.
I have no idea what Victor was trying to do there. Looked like he lost the handle or was going to try and pass it behind his back.
And Davis travels. The swap of turnovers. The Cyclones get it back.
Hawkeye zone has done a great job of collapsing, blocking up the middle. Here the ball seems to just be lost somehow. Victor Alexander, I really don't know what he was doing there. If he's going to go between his legs.
Street that time, providing pressure, making it difficult for Pearson to get the ball in bounds.
Street, a good athlete, 6'8", 6'9".
Thigpen's able to run it down. Exactly 4 minutes to go in the first half. Iowa State leading at 35-30. Scoreboard's been stuck there for a while. But Pearson unsticks it with his second three-pointer of the game. Turnover will give the Cyclones a chance to build on an 8-point lead. Kevin Smith about to come into the lineup for Tom Davis as he greets Troy Skinner on the sideline, and a timeout is taken. It comes with 3 minutes and 48 seconds to be played in an exciting first half that's seen both teams go up and down. We'll be right back after these messages from your local stations.
Hey, man, you know what it's like, cruising with a slice of pizza? All that gooey stuff was everywhere. But not a new Hardee's Pizza Pocket, man, because it's not a slice. So it doesn't make a mess. It just makes you feel, good. See, like, the only place that the mozzarella and the mozzarella and pepperoni goes is in your mouth, not like slices. Hey, Tony, looking good, man. What's happening? Hey, nice decoration, man. Good stuff.
You won't see very often. a red Cyclone sweater with an Iowa basketball button. But that guy's got a good reason to do it.
Yeah, that's Al Tubbs. That's Brig Tubbs' dad. And, of course, Al also played basketball, but he did it at Iowa State. And he is the next American Banker Association president, the ABA.
Hawks have yet to hit a three-pointer. Cyclones have tried a lot of them, and you saw their percentage there. Speaking of the Tubbs family, Al not the only Cyclone and Briggs family. His mother went to Iowa State, a couple of uncles, and the grandfather also went to Iowa State. But they never thought there'd be a day they would be rooting for the Hawks, huh? Kevin Smith all the way, and Dorfeld steps in to block, and a charge is called on Smith. Tom Davis stands up off the bench, hands on hips, and he finds the call hard to believe. But see if you see it a different way, Mac.
Smith likes the challenge. Here again, he could stop and pop it. He tries to take it all the way to the basket. Iowa State player, pretty good position that time.
So Iowa State with a 38-30 lead in the ball, 3:19 before halftime. Dorfeld tries to take Street inside. Big Pen fires. Six for Justice Big Pen. Most of them from that right baseline. For the Cyclones, perhaps their best half of the year, or at least since their opener, when they bombed Chaminade 112-85 in Hawaii.
And Iowa having trouble with some unforced turnovers.
Victor Alexander is going to get a rest. He's played a lot of time in this ballgame. Again, the turnovers, both coaches, I would think, could live with that. And interesting to note that Iowa State's taken advantage of the turnovers.
Now they've gotten six of them.
Cyclones trying to add to a 10-point lead. 2:40 to go first half. There's Bergman. Contact underneath. Val Barnes colliding with Paul Dorfeld. And it is Barnes who picks up the personal foul. His first. Called it on Kevin Smith instead of Barnes. And so now Iowa State's Pearson will trigger. Handling the ball about as long as they have in any possession thus far tonight. They've been doing a good job getting down, cranking it up in a hurley. This time they get it inside. Bergman off the fake pen. Bergman on the tip and Earl with the rebound.
You notice Iowa State much more patient with Victor out of there.
Barnes misses on the three and the ball out of bounds off of Iowa. Iowa State with the ball. 1:54 remains in half number one. Tom Davis, 3-1 against Iowa State.
And Tom Davis at the scorer's table.
I think he is going to question Ed Hightower about what we were questioning. Was that last foul on Smith, or was it, in fact, on Barnes? That may be what they're discussing. I thought sure that Hightower went over there with the 2-0 sign. The scoreboard put up 1-0, and of course, that's Smith's number. And now they are going to correct it, and it is on Barnes. It will be his first, and so now Smith back with one and Barnes with one.
Larry, way to be on top of your game. Good job.
Dorfeld pressured by Skinner. What?
I tell you, that's an alert job by the Iowa bench. Tom Davis and the assistants catching that, making sure it's corrected.
Big Pen leads it long. Webb with the rebound. The Jays got a bundle of them in this first half. Barnes hits the shot. It will count, and he will go to the line. A chance at a three-point play.
That is just a super job, being able to go ahead and control your body. Moses leading the break. And again, Moses, maybe last year would have taken a shot out of control. This time, he gives it up. And notice Barnes turning his body, turning that right shoulder, protecting the ball, going up strong. Moses, the assist.
Val Barnes having his best half as a Hawk, 7 of 11 from the floor, 14 points.
And that may be Iowa's first assist in this game.
Skip McCoy comes into the lineup for Iowa State at point guard. Brian Pearson has just drawn his third foul, so he will leave. McCoy, a freshman out of Gary, Indiana. 15 first half points for Barnes, his season high 20 a week ago tonight against Creighton.
And the Iowa State people really like McCoy's quickness.
Hasn't provided an offensive punch yet. In fact, has scored just 2 points in their first 7 games. But he scored 19 a game in high school. They figure he will soon. Here's Skinner. So the Hawks have scored 4 points in a row to bring it back to within 5. Dorfell on the drive.
Troy Skinner just gets run over at midcourt by Thigpen, and those two are discussing it right now, and officials in between them.
Skinner, Collins, and Thigpen all discussing this confrontation. There it is right there.
No foul called.
And there was the foul, A.C. Earl fouling Dorfeld. But Tom Davis is absolutely livid that the officials did not catch the collision just beyond the midcourt line.
The ball had rolled off the court. The officials went over to shoot a free throw. Couldn't find a basketball. This game does lack some continuity.
But it certainly does not lack intensity. Tom Davis doesn't get perturbed often, but when he does, you know about it.
Yeah. I would certainly understand that last call, or no call.
Cyclones go up by 6 on the Dorfeld free throw. Dorfeld coming off the bench against Baylor on Wednesday night. Did a nice job off the bench. 10 points and 6 rebounds. Rare he will miss a free throw.
Jay Webb just gets better and better every game, every rebound.
We're all trying to get around Van Carding and Dorfeld, but he does. Earl looks up for the first time, or one of the few times, doesn't see Victor Alexander in front of him, and he puts it down. To the final minute of the first half, down to 49 seconds.
And Iowa will obviously get the ball back once again.
The shot clock now at 25 and the game clock at 39, so Iowa could have it if Iowa State uses the whole shot clock at about 14 seconds to go in the half, and it looks like the Cyclones will do just that. Shot clock's at 13. The shot clock is at 5. Collins running to ad lib. Skinner fouls and disagrees with the call. And so do the Hawkeye partisans. Troy Skinner with his first foul.
A dig-in attempt right there by Skinner. Val Barnes had dropped down. Clock gets under 15. Skinner gets leather on that one. On the outside of that ball. Certainly didn't look like he came across the arm. That's one good thing young people ought to look at. Don't go across the arms. Try and just see daylight. Try and just find the ball. And he stripped it from the outside looking in.
This officiating in the last couple of minutes has not pleased Tom Davis. And Johnny Orr doesn't look especially pleased with this turn of events either. I think Hightower now goes to the official score. Seems to be a little lack of communication on that end tonight. When all is said and done, Collins will be at the line. He's one of the more respected officials in the country. Often you see him in the final four. He'll put 4 seconds back on the clock. As you noted in the replay, the clock continued to run after the foul had been called. Twelve in the first half for Collins. The Cyclones lead is 5. Ready? Now Moses will come in. Rodell Davis will leave. Iowa with the ball. 14.3 seconds to go in the half. Iowa State with the lead at 43-37. Cyclones will get one more opportunity. Too tall for Chappelle, and so the Hawkeyes will get one more opportunity with not much time left. Now Hightower goes flying over to the scorer's table. Tom Davis was up. And right now the official scorer and the timekeeper are certainly earning every cent that is paid them.
Well, you may have a situation where people end up watching the game more than the actual play situation that's going on. Two more seconds were put back on. Val Barnes may have taken that shot too early for Iowa. And then a poor judgment by Iowa State throwing a pass 40 feet when there's still plenty of time to get the shot off. 3 seconds, you can go the full length of the court on the dribble.
Earl from what you would consider out of his range, but not this time. A.C. Earl with a three at the horn.
Hey, that's a Wes Jepson three right there, Brad Lowhouse. Boy, that gets the Hawks fired up, and he has got to take the starch out of the Cyclones when you see that happen.
And see, with 1.4 seconds, Iowa doesn't get that shot off.
That's right. Very close if they would. 3 seconds, no question about it being good.
And so, an exciting first half of play. Everything you expect of an interstate rival between these two, we've had it all. At the half, Cyclones by three. Iowa State 43, Iowa 40. Tonight's game is being brought to you by Val Barnes leading the scoring.
Now you've got Rodell Davis, a surprise up there at 8 points. And then Jay Webb, Ace Earl just 5 points, and that includes his three-pointer.
Both teams have returned to the floor for what should be another action-packed half of basketball action. And we'll return to Carver Hawkeye Arena in just a moment.
I've always thought that putting down one piece of road was pretty much the same as any other. Then I found out that underneath all this asphalt, these guys are laying down this special fabric from Phillips 66. It's called Petromat. Now they say it'll not only make this piece of road last longer, it'll also make it safer. If Phillips 66 puts that much into a road, think how much they put into their gasolines.
Good thing for cars and the people who drive them.
December, get a great gift for coffee lovers. The Mr. Coffee 10 Cup Automatic Brewer from True Value Hardware Stores. It features automatic pause and serve, so you can get that first cup as it's brewing. And it has a warming plate to keep the coffee at the perfect temperature. In December, get the Mr. Coffee 10 Cup Automatic Brewer for just $14.99 while supplies last at participating True Value Hardware Stores and Home Centers.
Of all the world's car lines sold in this country, J.D. Power & Associates ranks only one American among the 10 most trouble-free. Buick. Before you put a new car in your garage, make sure it has one of these on the hood. The 1991 Buick Regal Sedan. Its powerful V6 engine gets an EPA estimated 30 miles per gallon on the highway. And that's making the imports nervous.
To you by Phillips 66 Petroleum and Budweiser. Now let's take a look at college basketball scores from around the country on our Budweiser scoreboard.
Well, Michigan State starting to get it back together a little bit, playing Ricky Birdsong, a former Iowa State player, scored just 20 points. Wisconsin, a loss. Duke getting Michigan.
Duke Michigan really, must have played pretty well there, though.
Yeah, I think Duke's a much stronger team. 7-point game is probably pretty good. Ohio State playing Chicago State. And there's the big one, Shaquille O'Neal. Boy, was he a dominant force. I'll tell you, talk about the best front line in basketball. Hey, there's Paul Lusk. Paulie here for the game. He said to say hi to his mom and dad, Paul and Joanne. He said, don't worry, I'm going to get a good grade out of that sociology class yet. He said, he'll be home as soon as finals are over.
That's first semester. They'll challenge you, won't they?
Yeah, and there's Johnny Orr. And I'll tell you, we want to wish Rami Orr speedy recovery. She had a little surgery, but I'm sure she's watching the game tonight.
Coming up next, a week from tonight, the Hawkeyes are going to take some time off and work on the books because final exams get underway at the university this week, and then they'll be back in action a week from tonight against Maryland, Baltimore County, and we'll have the action right here beginning at 7 o'clock. So road. 20 minutes of basketball left in regulation. Cyclones leading in the first half, as many as 12, now lead by 3. It'd be interesting to see what adjustments will have taken place. One thing that you know Iowa wants to do better is rebound better. They are not used to being out-rebounded. Another thing that Iowa State would like to do is to keep Victor Alexander in the game and out of foul trouble. And again, depth could become a factor for Iowa State with Coons not able to play tonight.
I was going to look right away and see what changes coaches make at halftime. That's critical to see if any other adjustments will be made during the first timeout. Right now, I would certainly expect Iowa to stay in that zone. It was very effective in the first half. Jay Webb, again, doing an outstanding job on the ball with that press and getting rebounds as the Palmer duo go against each other.
Both teams back to their starting fives, which means that AC Earl not in the lineup at the start for Iowa. He did not start the game tonight after being late to the team's practice today, and Brig Tubbs is in there in the middle instead. Here's Davis having it blocked by Alexander. Alexander was a demon on the boards for Iowa State in the first half. He came up with 8 rebounds. He was really a big factor in Iowa State having a rebound lead of 3.
And Iowa does start in their zone. Iowa State will try and spread it out. That's a travel. Jump ball.
And Hightower says jump ball, not a travel. And the possession arrow will keep it where it is at this end of the floor. So the Cyclones will play it. Brian Pearson to trigger. He had a couple of three-pointers in the first half. Big Penn out front. Hawks drop back into the zone, and Pearson fires over the zone. It will be Iowa basketball. Alexander touched it last.
And Iowa State challenges with their own pressure.
Davis guarded by Collins, who is perhaps the best defensive player for Iowa State. He's only 6'1", but he draws whoever, forward guard, whoever the top offensive threat of the opposition is.
And Coach Orr said he's probably even my best post-up defensive player.
A minute and 10 seconds have been played in the second half as Webb fires off the baseline and Alexander snares his 9th rebound. Iowa stays in the zone. Big Ten tries to penetrate it.
Dorfeld and Jay Webb going at it for position.
And now the rebound brought down by Brig Tubbs. Webb was the one who challenged for the rebound. Tubbs got the rebound. Jay Webb, Iowa's first half rebound leader with 6. Here's Brig Tubbs. And Iowa State's got it, and nobody has scored in the first almost 2 minutes of the second half. Now 2 minutes have been played in the second half. Scoreboard's still empty in this half.
Look at the two big men for Iowa State. They're standing around. There's not much exchange or movement. They just step in, try and get position on one side.
Dorfeld over Tubbs. And Paul Dorfeld has had an outstanding 11 points thus far. Dorfeld now 4 out of 6 from the floor.
Victor's trying to use his body for defense, and he's leaning on people, and he's going to get that call.
As Tubbs trying to get it inside to Webb, and Dorfeld is called on the holdout. Dorfeld with his second foul. It's the first called in the second half, and Johnny Orr will walk towards midcourt.
A screen right there, attempt by Webb. Then he steps right in to get the ball. Dorfeld, just a half step behind, gets the foul.
Webb finds Moses, who goes right to the paint. That time he got Collins in the air. He scores, and that's the first two by either team in the second half. Iowa to within 3. Excuse me, the first two by Iowa. Cyclones have a bucket already. And at the other end, AC Earl is whistled for the foul. For AC Earl, it will be foul number 2. At the line this year, Alexander 69%. He is 1 of 1 in this game. Iowa only to the line a Iowa State on the line seven times in the first half, but they made him count, hitting six of them.
You know, Larry, he really had an excellent sophomore season. Great things were expected. Last year he put on some extra weight, did not have a good year. This is the decision-making year. He's going to continue to play at a high level. He's going to have to show the NBA people that he can go a full 94 feet.
Barnes, pass underneath to Webb. Earl with an offensive rebound. And Dorfeld clears for the Cyclone.
ACO went and challenged Victor Alexander and did not get a call. Those arms were extended out over his body in front of it. There was no principal verticality in that situation.
Troy Skinner brings it up the floor for the Hawkeyes, with Iowa trailing 46-42.
Casey wants the ball. He wants to see if he can get that foul.
He's moving around a lot, and Alexander not necessarily following him as Val Barnes hits from three-point range. 18 for Val Barnes. Iowa back to within one. Hawks have never led in this game. The game was tied early at two, then the Cyclones first to a 12-point lead, and they've been up all the way.
When you saw Jay Webb raise his hand, he wants out. It'll be Winters coming in there. It will be Smith coming in for Troy Skinner.
By the way, that's the Tom Davis system. He wants his players to stay when they need a breather.
I tell you, that's a hard thing to teach. How many players do you know want to come out of the game? Not very many.
But this system really demands it.
You play so hard for two and a half, three and a half minutes, come out and get a 30-second rest.
Alexander gets the roll, and Victor Alexander with his first basket of the second half, his 10th point of the game, sends the Cyclones up by three, 48-45.
Not a good choice there, Larry.
Mark Chappelle into the lineup for Iowa State. He had that rebound. Cyclones have never trailed, and across the arm of Alexander is James Moses. First foul against Moses.
Alexander comes to the high post. Man's going to pick his pocket from behind. Again, slapping down, reaching down. Many times will be called because you'll catch the arm.
And a timeout's taken. 15:32 left in the ballgame. Iowa State maintains the lead. And we'll be right back at Carver Hawkeye Arena.
Well, it all started after my car here began to act up on me. It'd spit and sputter. It was hard to start. A buddy of mine suggested that I fill up with super clean unleaded gasoline from Phillips 66. I did, and it worked. Now it starts right, and it runs right. The problem wasn't my new car. It was my old gasoline.
Good things to cars and the people who drive them.
Through the ages, people have gone to great lengths to cover their feet. For hard work, for hard play.
Today, things are a lot easier with Rockport shoes. Rockports are dress and casual shoes that feel like tennis shoes and look great, too. And best of all, you don't have to go far to get a pair of Rockports. With a Walker shoe store just around the corner, all you do is walk into Walker's and walk into the age of comfort. Call 1-800-779-SHOE for the Walker store nearest you.
Walk into Walker's.
Holiday greetings from Budweiser. The people who bring you Budweiser wish you and yours the very best of everything this holiday season.
Cyclones have led all the way. Their current margin is 3 at 48-45. But for Iowa, Val Barnes having his best offensive night thus far with a total of 18 points.
Ball reversal. Moving the ball on the perimeter. Man pops out, gets squared up. You see Val Barnes knocking down that three. He's got 18 in this game.
15 and a half remains. What a matchup that is. Former high school teammates Alexander again wheeling inside of Earl. Alexander now two baskets in the last two Cyclone possessions, and they lead by 5, 50 to 45. Timeout, Kevin Smith inserted into the Hawk lineup. Earl wants to answer Alexander and does. Just his third basket. Davis on the steal.
Great choice by a freshman guard. In traffic, a lot of times people would panic, want to go up with it, want to force something. Brings it out, restart.
Smith gets around Chappelle. And the ball locked out of bounds. The officials confer. Ed Hightower comes over from the far side of the floor to the near side to say it belongs to Iowa. Winners out, Webb back into the Iowa lineup, and it'll be Webb inbound. 50-47 Cyclones. Grab the high post pick. Goes Smith. What's the reverse? Good defense by Iowa State's Collins to stick right with him, though. Collins now at the other end scores. 15 for Collins.
And Iowa still looking to draw that third foul on Victor Alexander.
Earl backing Alexander down, which is no easy chore as big as Alexander is. He's listed at 6'9", 265. Earl, by contrast, 225. So listed some 40 pounds lighter. And the Cyclones come out with a Dorfeld. 3-on-2 break.
Ragged play, but you've got to say it is great hustle, exciting. People trying to make the defensive play.
Neither coach will be unhappy with the intensity of this game.
But they may be a little dissatisfied with execution.
They may be.
Each team had a position to move out 5 or 6 points. Nobody came away with anything.
This is Chappelle trying to penetrate. Alexander with yet another rebound. A.C. Earl blocks it. A.C. Earl, who last year led the Big Ten in block shots with 50, says he'd like 100 this year. He's well on the way, already has 30.
Right now, the legs are gone. You can tell the shooters just not been able to get their legs into it at all. The pace has been torrid.
Yeah, therefore a slow start offensively to the second half. Pearson bombs away. Again, Alexander rebound. Again, Alexander rebound. 14 for Victor Alexander. He has really become a force inside in the last several minutes of the game.
And Alexander that time just pushed A.C. Earl. Nothing called, I'll tell you. And Alexander wants out. He's tired.
Johnny Orr will get him out the next time he can. Exactly a dozen minutes left in this ballgame as Skinner wants to take Pearson inside, and Pearson fouls. And that will be his fourth. Let's get a look at this block.
Alexander pumping, and you've got A.C. Earl ready to time it. Goes up, slaps it, gets the ball, and may have gotten some skin with that too. But that isn't the first time that's happened between those two in this game.
Not at all. So now Pearson, four fouls for Iowa State, and that becomes a factor because their number two point guard is a freshman. Victor Alexander now 11 rebounds. Here's Pearson leaving in favor of Skip McCoy. The freshman's going to be under some pressure now because we still have lots of time left in this game. 11:59 to play as the timeout is taken. Tom Davis and James Moses, quite a discussion. And he wants Moses to go over to Ed Hightower and talk about some play on the floor. Could have been maybe the Alexander push, but anyway, Moses talks to Ed Hightower. We'll be right back following these messages from your local station. Must be especially tough for Wade Looking Bill to sit this one out, being an Iowa native.
Talked to Tom Davis today about making an offense go. One of the things that makes Tom's offense go is screening ability. Right there you saw what Tom considers his best screener. Looking Bill out, his second best screener, Paul Lusk. Both of them out for the year.
Bergman in for Alexander. Alexander needing the rest, and so Bergman comes off the bench. 11:45 left. McCoy, who's got a lot of responsibility on his shoulders now with Pearson in foul trouble. Here is Moses left open on one of his favorite spots on the floor. Second bucket for Moses, 7 points in the game. Cyclone lead is reduced to five.
Now you see Chris Street at the back of the press playing the power, playing the post position. He had been a power forward most of the year.
Putting the follow through, Mike Bergman. His first basket, but it's a big one in this game. A 7-point lead for Iowa State. Barnes connects again. He has been outstanding from both inside and outside.
Iowa State lost Val Barnes. I don't know how you can lose a guy that's scoring 20 points.
And that equals his career high, by the way, at 20 a week ago tonight against Creighton. Barnes has 20 tonight. The Cyclone Brain Trust call their group over. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express prior written consent of the Big Ten Conference Incorporated is prohibited. 10 minutes, 46 seconds to play. Victor Alexander remains on the Cyclone bench. Iowa State remains in the lead at 56-51.
And you have Chris Street still at the back of the press, playing the post position, matching up with Bergman.
Which means that while Alexander is resting, AC Earl is resting.
And both of them needed it. They were tired people out there.
With McCoy in at the point with Pearson on the bench with four fouls. Shot clock is down to 16 for the Cyclones. Shot clock's at 8. The shot clock is at 3. Collins knows it.
And Iowa State gets to start all over again.
Bergman keeping the rebound alive, missing the shot. Kevin Smith now pushes up the floor for the Hawks, who trail by 5. Street offensive rebound and bucket. And he is fouled and the basket will count. Chris Street, his first Hawkeye basket.
And that's what he needed to do, become more aggressive. Smith, looking for the three. His foot just slips over the line. It would have been a 2, but Street continues to come directly at the basket, get himself in rebounding position. And the Waverly native, Bergman, says, what foul?
And that for Bergman would be his second. Street completes the 3-point play. Now a 2-point game, and the Hawks apply pressure. Iowa State really struggling with that pressure. Collins is able to beat it. Charge on Collins.
That's a different dimension to the back of the press, where AC Earl gives you the shot blocking ability. Chris Street, quicker feet, athletically sets himself to look for that charge. 4-on-1. Have to make better decisions than try and go through people. Give up the ball on the bounce pass to the chest. Either one.
Iowa looks to tie it up with the 2. Go ahead with the 3. Alexander, the big man, inside, back in for Iowa State. Webb challenges him. And the rebound is taken down by the Cyclones. Big Ten all the way for the layup. His first basket of the second half, and Iowa State goes up by 4. So the Hawks a chance to tie it with the 2. Couldn't get the job done. The Cyclones able to score at the other end and stretch the lead to 4. And a chance with more on the turnover by Moses.
Iowa in position to get that tired lead. Iowa State, patient. Stretching it out to a 4 points.
AC Earl and others to come in for Iowa next time the ball is dead. Cyclones adjusting to the zone much better in the second half than they did in the first half. An example right there. The Dorfell misfires and the ball goes in. Alexander will get credit for it.
Yeah, Alexander was the only person there.
16 for Alexander along with 13 rebounds. moves around the pitch to score. 22 for Barnes and a new Hawkeye high for him.
Great high post pick that time.
Alexander on the feet from Thigpen, and Alexander has really played well for Iowa State tonight. It's a Cyclone lead of six. We have 7:50 to go, and Barnes underneath.
Barnes pushed out of bounds. Nothing called.
And he has not yet gotten up. Barnes is still down. Barnes got shoved.
This game, honestly, Larry, has gotten out of hand physically.
John Streep over to take a look at him. Tom Davis on the bench, gesturing at the official. He was pushed. Now Davis will say something to the official as he walks over to attend to Val Barnes. He is furious. Hawkeyes already plagued with injuries to Looking Bill and Lust. Can ill afford another.
Looks like an ankle. 2 foot jump stop goes up. Comes down with Victor on his back. Dorfeld there. Looks like his right ankle.
Wonder if Dorfeld didn't accidentally land on that ankle. 7 minutes, 45 seconds to play. Barnes out for at least a while as Johnny Orr has seen his team in the throes of a six-game losing streak, trying to snap it on the road in Iowa City tonight. I have of Val Barnes. If there's any way he can play, he will. He's a tough young man. The three-pointer canned by Brian Pearson.
He had two of them in the first half. You got to recognize that. Go out on the shooter.
And a Hawkeye turnover gives the Cyclones the chance to make this a double-figure lead. Big Pen. Winners with a rebound. Iowa State getting down well defensively. Skinner for three.
The Palmer shootout. Let's play horse.
They've done that many times before. Three at either end that time. Just under 7 minutes to play. Iowa State with a 65-59 lead.
Rodell Davis will have to watch Pearson on the perimeter. He can't get much help down low.
Shot clock down to 15. Cyclones have been taking a little bit more time off that clock. Winters trying to keep the ball out of Alexander's hands. Not an easy chore. And Alexander will go to the line. Winters, 6'5", a good leaper, trying to defend 6'9", Victor Alexander.
Patient offense by Iowa State. Alexander is so big. Once he gets the ball, it's difficult to get to him to bother it. Especially Winters, just 6'5".
Alexander with 18 points as he goes to the line. For the Stripe, he's 2 out of 3. Top 10 in both career scoring, as you see there, and career rebounding at Iowa State. And he has really played well. Double figures, points and rebounds on the Hawkeye bench.
Ready?
Kevin Smith getting some assistance. Has at least 13 rebounds. DC Earl makes the move on Alexander. And a foul spotted underneath. And it will go against Iowa State.
Inside move, AC Earl, double pumping, trying to go up. Again, Alexander has his arms extended out in front of his body. That should be a foul on Alexander. Straight up, it's an offensive foul. Then it would be on AC Earl.
Dorfeld got that last one, his third. Collins with the takeaway for the Cyclones. Iowa State by 7, 5:53 to play. Cyclones really doing a good job on the board.
Right now, they're very quick to the ball. Loose balls. Rebounds. And Kevin Smith went to the locker room. You don't know what's wrong with him, but he is not on the bench. just coming back now. So that was a quick exit and return.
Rebound underneath Bud Collins. He got position that time, but a double dribble is called, and the Hawkeyes will get the ball. Iowa ball, 5:27 to play. The Hawkeyes trail by 7, and Smith now will come into the lineup.
I really believe at this point it's going to be patience and poise down the stretch, the last 5.5 minutes. There's going to be plenty of scoring opportunities, just which of these two teams plays better under the pressure of the game. Both Iowa teams. With a lot of inexperience, Larry, excuse me, while Iowa State, more experience.
Alexander Alpert Pearson, who plays with 4 fouls, of course, is now on the floor, has been for a couple of minutes for Iowa State. Hawkeyes losing Val Barnes to that ankle injury. And there is a foul called. Earl that time battling with Bergman. And AC picked up the personal.
I'll tell you. That time AC is trying to establish position. This has just been a very rugged interior game.
Third foul on Earl. Hawkeyes 4 as a team, Cyclones 5 as a team. 5:05 to go. It is really rough. Big Ten will wait for the Cyclone offense to come down. Bergman rebounds a miss by Pearson. And a foul spotted on the Hawks. Moses that time trying to get to the basketball. And for Moses, it is his second foul. Iowa now with 5. Bergman will be at the line, but first the timeout is taken. Hawks want to use this timeout with 4 minutes and 51 seconds left to play. The Cyclones have led all the way except for one time when the game was tied at 2. They're trying to hang on as the Hawks try to roar back. We'll be right back after these messages from your local stations.
Pioneer Brand 3362.
How long have your spices been sitting there, growing old, weak, and stale? Replace them with Tones, pure natural spices specially sealed to lock in freshness, and small enough so you can use them up long before they go stale. Spices don't stay fresh forever. Fortunately for you, there's Tones, Iowa's own spice company since 1873.
Perhaps the greatest gift you can give your family this holiday season is the gift of health. The gift of secure and affordable care by superior physicians and specialists who are always there when you need them. Perhaps the greatest gift you can give your family this holiday season is the gift of HMO Iowa. HMO Iowa is healthcare you can feel good about, now and throughout the new year.
Bergman behind Earl. You see Bergman having his hands low, pushing AC in the middle of the back. He's grabbing around and reaching. That's a foul on Bergman. Nothing called yet. AC decides to take it into his own hands, pushes off, and raises the elbow. That's the foul he called on AC Earl, but there was plenty of contact prior to that by Bergman.
Mike Bergman to the line. 2 points in the game thus far. 4:51 left. Cyclones with a 66-59 lead. Val Barnes shaken up earlier with that bad ankle, back onto the floor at that timeout. 4:46 left to play. Iowa trailing by 7 as they clear the right side for Smith, who dishes to Earl. And AC will get a chance at the line.
Dorfeld goes down, but through his years at Iowa State, he's known as the Lambeer flop upon occasion. AC Earl, good pick and roll.
Earl trying to get it to go down, does not, and he goes to the line. And Dorfeld with four.
He has four. Pearson has four. So the Cyclones have foul difficulty. The Hawks have nobody with more than three, and that's the man at the line, A.C. Earl. You see a 65% free throw shooter on the year. That was his first attempt tonight. You see a non-starter tonight after showing up late for practice, but he's seen lots of playing time. He pulls Iowa back to within six with 4:39 to play. Alexander again goes to the hole, and A.C. Earl with the block and the rebound. Big play by A.C. Barnes for three. Pearson with a rebound. Collins on the penetration. Foul by Smith. Second foul on Kevin Smith.
Good open court move that time by Collins. A little earlier. Nice dish. A.C. Earl rejects it. Comes up from behind. Doesn't come across the arms. That's what makes him such a great shot blocker. He doesn't challenge in front of you. He waits, lets you go by, and then picks the ball.
Cyclones are their best free throw shooter on the line, and Collins, and he now has 16 points. You look at Victor Alexander, what a night he's had. 19 points, 14 rebounds.
Of course, Dorfeld, 10 rebounds.
And I go back to something I said earlier. I think rebounding, a big factor in this ballgame. Cyclones have not done it especially well this year. They have been out-rebounded an average of 4.5 a game, but tonight they are doing a much better job on the board. Barnes is fouled by Thigpen, who went for the block. Thigpen now with his third foul.
A good read that time by Val Barnes. Instead of going over the top of the two-man game, he brought the crossover dribble back right down the lane. Kept himself in balance by staying low as he could penetrate the lane.
Barnes, a career high, 22 points. Val Barnes really took over down the stretch on Tuesday night against Northern Iowa. In fact, 10 of his last 12 points came in the last 6 minutes as he scored 10 of Iowa's final 17 points. He's a young man who wants the ball in crunch time. Cyclones having trouble with the pressure. A.C. Earl almost got the steal and then almost decked Ed Hightower. Pearson inbound for Iowa State with 4:04 remaining.
You see Webb on the ball. Difficult to find somebody.
Alexander and Dorfeld with the rebound, his 11th rebound. Dorfeld and Alexander on the boards, 25 between them. Here's Thigpen. And Jay West comes up with a rebound for the Hawks. Hawkeyes try to cut a 6-point Cyclone lead. Barnes.
You don't tell great players what to do. They just do it.
A Tom Davis quote from earlier in the game, and we talked about it on Tuesday night. He does play well down the stretch. He wants that basketball. Alexander is fouled by Earl. Alexander a chance at a three-point play as AC has drawn his fourth. And Alexander with 21 points.
And a defensive mix-up. Jay Webb was looking around. He left Alexander. Can't leave the big guy. He wants the ball. He'll score.
Hawks making a couple of changes as Webb and Moses go out. Rodell Davis comes back in for Iowa. And there's what Tom Davis was talking about earlier today, specifically referring to Val Barnes. Underneath it is Barnes. And a foul is spotted. Foul called on Iowa State. 3:16 to play. Cyclones lead Iowa 70-64. Drawing the foul. Thigpen, and for him that will be four fouls. So now Thigpen, Pearson, and Dorfeld all with four fouls apiece for Iowa State. Skinner wants to come in probably for the shooter, Val Barnes.
That's exactly right.
Barnes makes him. Now Iowa to set up the press. Skinner will get in. Bell will get a little bit of a rest before he comes back in for the final charge for the Hawkeyes. Iowa State has done an outstanding job with poise getting the ball to the big man. They have really played hard.
What a night for Val Barnes. Now he will get a rest. Skinner is in. The Hawks set up the press. 3:16 to play. A 4-point Iowa State lead.
And he
walked. Big Ten walked. Traveling violation on Big Ten. Johnny Orr is chagrined. He wants a timeout. 3:13 left to play. It will be Iowa ball when play resumes. Timeout on the floor. 3:13 left. Cyclones 70. Hawkeyes 66. We'll be right back following these messages.
A performance story from Phillips 66. Subject, the environment. The fragile, the beautiful, the irreplaceable. How do we help ensure they'll remain part of our environment? Example, this water treatment system made with a Phillips plastic that helps keep our rivers clean, clear, and alive. Phillips 66, you'll find performance in everything we do.
This is the only homeowner with better protection than a homeowner's policy from Farm Bureau. Homeowner's insurance protection that leaves the others behind from Farm Bureau. This is the simple idea behind the farm owner's policy from Farm Bureau. Adjustable farm insurance coverage to fit your needs.
Iowa State basketball game. It's been intense. It's been fierce. It's been quite physical. Cyclones with the lead. Foul problems have to concern both coaches.
Well, on the Iowa side, A.C. Earl just won, but he's a big one. The other side, Pearson, Dorfeld, and Big Pim.
And, of course, they're all starters. The clear out for Kevin Smith. Xander has his 15th rebound for Iowa State. Underneath, Dorfeld, offensive foul, and Dorfeld is fouled out. Dorfeld fouls out with 2:47 to play.
Boy, you just look at Val Barnes, how he's played this game, taking every hit of both ends. Looks like he should be a defensive back the way he plays it. Sliding over, trying to establish position. Dorfeld takes it to the basket. Baseline, Barnes knows it's the only chance he has against a 6'8 player to try and take that charge. And Dorfeld's gone.
He totaled 11, got only two in the second half.
And calls like that can happen at home. They may not happen on the road.
With 2:47 left to play, and the Hawkeyes play from the backcourt. Troy Skinner will bring it up for Iowa. Iowa has never led in this game. Earl wants the ball over Berkman. Five and a half now, and 10 in the game for A.C. Earl, and it's a two-point game. This is Collins.
Iowa State had a two-on-one break. But A.C. Earl back there makes him think about it.
Just like last year's game, Mac, could be determined on the final shot. A great rivalry between these two.
The game the last 4 or 5 minutes has finally gotten a rhythm. Up till then, it was very hard to find out and establish a good rhythm to this game.
Shot clock's at 8. Bergman will take it with a shot clock at 5. The three by the big guy. Mike Bergman at 6'8 hits from a three-point range, and it's a big bucket for the Cyclones to go up by 5. And now time and number of possessions really becomes a factor. Iowa can ill afford to squander a possession without a score. And Wolf will go to the line. Alexander has fouled for the third time.
But he's been called for.
That's what the official score has, three fouls on Victor Alexander. A lot of people would tell you that there have been more, huh?
There's been a lot of banging on the inside. A good dump pass by A.C. Earl there, and a good foul that time by Iowa State.
Austin struggled at the free throw line for the most part this season. Jay Webb, one of those struggling, 57% on the year, and one out of two tonight. Webb gets the bounce as Kevin Smith will come in for Iowa, replacing Troy Skinner. It is now a four-point Cyclone lead, 1:27 to go. Now a three-point Iowa State lead. And here comes James Winters into the lineup, replacing Jay Webb. So Webb would struggle at the line, hits a couple of clutch free throws there to pull the Hawkeyes to within three. Alexander feels it against pressure. Cyclones now will take some time, look for a good shot.
And the Hawkeyes have to go man-to-man.
And they trap and they force the jump ball, and the possession arrow will give it to the Hawkeyes. Big defensive stand by Iowa. They get the ball back, trailing by three.
Once again, the quickness. Kevin Smith makes the man pick up the dribble, a double team, and the man brings the ball down, doesn't step through it, tied up. Now Iowa, as Iowa State goes to zone, they're going to protect, make Iowa look for that three-point shot.
Barnes for three, it's tied up.
Oh, is that some kind of player?
What a final five-minute player Val Barnes has become already in his young Hawkeye career, just this week alone.
There's a shot clock. That 10 seconds difference, Larry, on the shot clock.
So the Cyclones will have to shoot, and Iowa will get another possession.
You're looking at the game clock.
About an 8-second difference, shot clock to game clock. Cyclones want a timeout. There will be 15 on the shot clock, and what you're looking at is the game clock, which shows 23.2 seconds. And that's the situation when we return. Game is all tied up. It's another one right down to the wire. Back to a sold-out Carver Hawkeye Arena in a moment.
This is never going to work.
Hey, relax. Anybody can send them roses.
Excuse me, we didn't order these. Ian, what's this?
Hi!
Did they really expect us to call them?
I'm telling you.
Hello!
You can do it with true value.
It's the season for handy household gifts. Like the Plano Stowaway Organizer with removable drawers. It's only $9.99. And the whole family can use the GE battery recharger with two bonus batteries, just $14.99. Or give the Master Electrician Maglite flashlight with flood to spot focus. Holiday priced at only $16.99 at participating True Value hardware stores and home centers.
It's Cyclone basketball as play resumes. With 15 left on the shot clock, 23.2 on the game clock, and the Cyclones out of timeouts.
Cyclones zero timeouts, but Iowa still has two. You would have to think right now, Tom Davis has talked about, if Iowa State makes or misses, what the options will be for the Hawkeyes. This is only the second time the score has been tied. The other time was at 12 apiece.
Steals for Iowa. The Hawks have the possession, and they can take the last shot.
And right,
AC Earl, a huge steal for Iowa. Iowa's got the ball with 20 and a half seconds left to play, and a timeout taken by the Hawkeyes.
Brian Pearson taking the ball out of bounds in about 6'3". Jay Webb, 6'9", in front of him, deflected that pass,
as Pearson cannot move. This is a set position on the sideline. He has to stay put. Jay Webb can attack. He gets the tip there. Then AC Earl, the 6'10 man, goes and gets it.
So it's Hawkeye ball in a game that's tied at 73. 20 and a half seconds remain. Back with the conclusion of regulation. We're going to stay right here with the action right down to the wire. Tonight's game has been brought to you by Budweiser, Amana, True Value Hardware, and Phillips 66 Petroleum. They're on their feet at Carver Hawkeye Arena for the last 20 and a half seconds. Hawkeye ball, game tied. Barnes has had the hot hand. What do you think will happen for the last shot?
I've got to bet somehow Val Barnes will get the opportunity to have the basketball. The other thing, the other guard in there now is Kevin Smith, who is maybe the Iowa's quickest offensive player with the basketball. He'll try and go get it. Then he will have options. I would say now, whether he wants to go ahead and take it or find Val Barnes. And here comes Val looking. Clock's going down to 10 seconds.
Smith takes the shot. Davis fights for the rebound, and Iowa still has it. Hawks ball, 4.2 seconds left in regulation.
Rodell Davis is the key man. He triggers it. Iowa has two timeouts. If he doesn't like what he sees, Rodell can still take a timeout for Iowa to reset it.
And again, he cannot move.
Smith is out, Troy Skinner in. Two shooters on the perimeter for Iowa.
Here is Val Barnes for the game winner. The tip is good by Rodell Davis at the horn, and the Hawkeyes have won.
It is a win. I was waiting to see if the officials were going to count it or not. Hawkeyes win it on the tip. Val Barnes missed shot.
Iowa's only lead of the game comes on their final basket.
And Rodell Davis played an excellent game, being strong on the inside. Kicks the ball to the corner. Val Barnes makes his move. Has to get it off over three Cyclones. Going up, Davis tips 0.3 seconds left.
What a finish, Rodell Davis. 6'3", leaping as high as he could. And watch Rodell all the way here.
Barnes again winding the ball. Rodell, all the Cyclones go to the ball. Rodell has inside perfect position. And it's good. Hawkeyes only lead.